Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Our Father, we just want to say thank you very much. Today is the last fellowship in the month of 2021. Father, we thank you for all that you've done for us so far, right from January through to December. Like that one leper, we have come to say thank you. And we are trusting in you that today, as we come to end our fellowship with you in dancing and praising you for the great things you have done for us, Father in heaven, we are believing you that all that are left for us in 2021 before 31st of, on or before 31st of December 2021, we will surely get it in the name of Jesus. We will surely get them in the name of Jesus. And as we are going to dance our way into 2022, Father in heaven, we are believing in you that every miracle that you have destined for us come 2022, will surely get to us at the right time in the name of Jesus. There's no one who will come before the Almighty God, blessing and praising him, will return back without being blessed. We shall all be blessed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Once again, brethren, I welcome you to our fellowship this morning for us logging in from Nigeria, from Europe. God bless you for logging in. And our brethren logging in from US and Canada, I said good evening and God bless you. The Lord God Almighty this day, he will make sure that all our blessings for 2021, they will not go with the year. On or before 31st of December, the Lord will ensure that those miracles get to us in the name of Jesus. Now, I just have a few things to share with us and then we will now hand over to our music director who will lead us in praising the Almighty God. And I want to believe that you have come with your dancing shoe, because today we are going to dance and dance and dance and dance and dance. We are going to dance and praise God for the next 20 minutes. And as we are dancing and praising God, I want you to begin to picture what you want God to do for you. Brethren, picture what God wants to do for you. Have a picture of where you are going to. Have a picture of your future in you. That is what we call destiny. A picture of your future. A preferable picture of your future. Have it in your heart as you are dancing, as you are praising God. Begin to praise God and have that picture. For those who want to get married next year, have that picture of getting married in your heart as you are praising God. For those who want to get pregnant, have that picture of being pregnant come 2022 and be praising him. I'm telling you, whatever you are expecting from the Almighty God, begin to dance, dance. Don't look at the impossibility. Don't look at how God is going to do it. It doesn't matter. That's not your headache. That's not my headache. I don't need to think about how will God do it. All I need to think about is that God, this is my desire. This is what I'm expecting come 2022. And I'm telling you, and as you do that, you will see the miracles happening. Because the Bible tells me that Abraham, he was glorifying God. He was glorifying God, full of praises unto God, because he was fully persuaded that what God has promised him, what was in his mind, the picture he had was that the picture of Isaac, Isaac being conceived and being born. And he praised God with that picture in his mind. And you know, God did not disappoint him. Him and his wife, they were dancing and praising God. And suddenly, in the name of Jesus, as you two begin to praise God, beginning from today, dancing in his presence, and suddenly, that picture you have in your heart for 2022, you will see it coming to pass in your life. In the name of Jesus. Brethren, just quickly give me about 5 minutes or so and I'll be done. And then we'll now hand over to our music director. Hallelujah. Once again, I want to continue from where we stopped about 2 weeks ago on Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving, God's password. It is the password of God. And I'm taking my scripture reference from Psalm 100 from verse 4 to 5. And I'm reading it from Message Translation. He said, Enter with the password. Thank you. Make yourself at home, talking praise. Thank him, worship him. And verse 5 says, for God is sheer beauty, all generous in love, loyal always and ever. Remember, we said that about 2 weeks ago, also that from Psalm 100, verse 4, we said that thanksgiving is God's password. And for us to assess God or to get God's attention, we need to use God's password. Hallelujah. For instance, if your phone or your laptop has been passworded, the only way by which you can legitimately access the contents in your phone or your laptop is using that password. Without the password, you cannot access your phone or your laptop. Thanksgiving is God's password, or it is God's passcode to access God without any stress. It is God's legitimate way of accessing him, and that is thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving can also be likened to a master key to open the door into God's presence. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, we said thanksgiving can also be likened to a master key to open the door into God's presence. There's a door. That was why he says that enter into his gate with thanksgiving and enter into his presence. There's a door. You know, there's a door. There's a gate. When you want to go enter a house, you see a gate. That gate is the entrance. But for that, for you to enter to God's presence, you must pass through that entrance. And the entrance is, hallelujah, thanking the Almighty God. And I want you to believe, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. And I want to believe that you understand what we mean by God's presence. For you to enter into God's presence, the one that calls himself I am that I am, you need to use the password of the Almighty God. Whatever challenge that follows you into God's presence will disappear. For no challenge can stand God's presence. Whatever is that challenge, whatever it is, whether it's delay in marriage or delay in pregnancy or delay in whatever God has promised you and there's a delay on it, when you are entering into God's presence with thanksgiving, that thing will fall off. That thing will fall off. And I prophesy in the name of Jesus, because the Bible tells me that in his presence, there's fullness of joy. Whatever sorrow, whatever bitterness that has followed you into God's presence, gives way in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In John chapter 1, verse 1 to 5 says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness. That's what we're talking about. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness can comprehend it not. Brethren, when you begin to praise God, because in God's presence is God's light. And when light shines, I'm telling you, that darkness will go away. Thank you, Jesus. Brethren, let me show you what God is going to do for you and for me as we joyfully praise and dance before him this day. I want you to open your Bible or just listen to me. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20. Verse 20 says, early the next morning, they marched out to the desert of Tekoa. When they were ready to march, Jehoshaphat stood up and said, listen to me, you people of Judah and residents of Jerusalem. Trust in the Lord your God, and you will be saved. Brethren, this is the same message God is giving to you and me, that we should trust in him, and we shall be saved. Brethren, I don't know the challenge you are carrying. I don't know the problem in your life. I don't know the kind of calamity that has befallen you. I don't know where the enemy has been attacking you. But it says that trust in the Lord. They were about to face their own challenge that was above them. But Joseph, as the leader, as I also, by the grace of God, God has made me a leader in the name of Jesus, Joshua encouraged them and told them that, look, Trust in the Lord and your God, and you will be saved. Trust in the message of his prophet, and you will win. Brethren, I decree and I declare that you will win this day. Beginning from today, today being our last day of our fellowship in 2021, you will surely win all your battles of life. I say you will surely win all your battles of life. In verse 21, he then consulted with the people and appointed musicians. We too were also appointed a musician through a recorded music. We are going to also dance as they, appointed some musicians to play with instruments. We too, we have a group of people who came together and play instruments for us to dance before the Almighty God. And that was what they did. And the Bible told us that as they march ahead of the warriors, they said, give thanks to the Lord, for his loyal love endures. You see, we too have come to give thanks unto the Lord, dancing before the Almighty God. And what happened when they were doing it? What happened? That's exactly what God's going to do. I'm telling you, whoever are those enemies in your life, whatever are those things that post themselves as enemies in your life, as you begin to appreciate God with dancing this day, as you begin to dance before the Almighty God, see what God's going to do. God is going to, like we are told, that as they began to praise God, suddenly, the Ammonites and the Moabites and the men from Mount Seir who were invading Judah, three nations, powerful nations with all the artillery. What did God do? They were all defeated. Hallelujah. How did God do it? God launched an attack. God launched a surprise attack against them. Hallelujah. Three nations that came against Israel, they were all defeated. They were all killed. How did they kill? They began to kill themselves. Your enemy will kill themselves. I decree, I say, your enemies will kill themselves. As you begin to praise the Almighty God, your enemies will kill themselves in the name of Jesus. God will come down. And what brought God down? Those against people had prayed. But when they now switch from prayer into praising God and dancing before him, before the musician, and they began to dance before God, God could not resist their praises. And God had to come down. And the Bible told us that God launched an attack. Sudden attack, a surprise attack. God will launch a surprise attack against all your enemies in the name of Jesus. Enemies that have been appearing in your dream, tormenting you, God is going to launch an attack against them in the name of Jesus. And God will come back and God will make sure that they begin to kill themselves. That was what he did here. Three nations came, and one nation faced the other nation. They agreed to come to fight the children of Israel. But when they got to the battlefield, what happened? God began to turn their heart against themselves. God will turn the heart of your enemies against themselves in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Before, they were in agreement. But today, as we are praising God, God will turn their heart against each other and they'll begin to fight themselves. And you will hear it in the name of Jesus. They'll begin to expose themselves and you will hear it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Until the last person kills himself. Thank you, Jesus. Your enemy will kill himself. Your enemy will kill themselves in the name of Jesus. But you just begin to praise the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Look at verse 23. The Ammonites and the Moabites attacked the men from Mount Seir and completely destroyed them. When they had finished off the men of Seir, they attacked and destroyed one another. They helped destroy one another. I want you to put it down on the dashboard. They helped to destroy one another. And say that, and now put it there. My enemies will help each other to destroy themselves. My enemies will help each other to destroy themselves. And that will be your experience this day. Effort. That will be your experience in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. See, now before I hand over to our music director to lead us in the praise worship, brethren, I want you in the next 20 minutes put on your video, switch off your audio because we are recording. Hallelujah. But you can put on your video if you have light. Put on your video and dance. Hallelujah. I'm going to dance now. I'm going to stand up and start my dancing. But remember what the Lord said to me some days ago concerning next year. He said, 2022, my year of great possibility. I want you to write it down on your dashboard. As you are writing it down, so shall it be unto you. As you are writing it down, so shall it be unto you. 2022, my year of great possibility. And the Lord gave us a scripture as our anchor scripture for next year. He said, For with God, all things are possible. For with God, all things are possible. For with God, all things are possible. Whatever has been impossible in your life in 2021, for with God, 2022, it shall be possible. I say, it shall be possible. My year of great possibilities. My year of great possibilities. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Right now, it's time. Get ready. We want to go into the praise worship now. Remember, brethren, pray your way. The Lord said that in your pain, praise me, and you will see my glory. The Lord said, and I'm connecting myself to this prophetic word. I keep myself into this prophetic word. Write it also. Say, in your pain, praise me, and you will see my glory. In your pain, praise me, and you will see my glory. In your pain, praise me, and you will see my glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, Dr. Precious, over to you now. It's time to praise and to dance before the altar. Hallelujah. It's time now to dance before the Almighty God. I want you to get ready as Dr. Precious will lead us in the danceable song. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, There is something that makes me come into your presence. Listen up. It's a mercy that gives me access to your presence, everybody.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If you believe the Lord God Almighty, if you believe that the Lord God Almighty has heard you, can I hear your powerful hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
As you have danced before the Almighty God, as you have danced before the Almighty God, the Lord God Almighty will come down in the name of Jesus and fight your battles for you in the name of Jesus. As he came down, so Kenapa Pali Kadena so Tony Kela Osata, Lekote Napara Kusete Napapaya Kate Nekuria Alike Satina Kuria. Because we have come to do exactly what Jehoshaphat and his team did. We came to do exactly what Jehoshaphat and his team did. Oh, and you came down to fight their battles. We too have come from a grateful heart. We have come to also dance into your presence. Therefore, you are not a partial God. You will do exactly what you did. And right now, as we have come to dance, as I went to our breakthrough, Father in heaven, all our miracles that are yet to manifest, miracles that are meant for 2021, that are yet to manifest. Now that we have 2 days to go, Father, you said that when we place you in our pain, you said that you will come down and you show that you manifest your glory in our life. Therefore, right now we demand for our glory. In the name of Jesus. Father, we demand our glory to manifest now. In the name of Jesus. For those that have come, Father, trusting in you for the foot of the womb. That womb is open. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Brethren. Brethren, let me encourage you. God is working on this platform. I'm convinced. I am telling you, I am convinced. If you are not sure, I am sure. Because I deal with the people. I call them to get the feedback. Just about 3 days ago, I called one of our sisters who has been trusting God for the fruit of the womb for some years now. And I just asked her, I just said to check you up. How are you doing? And how far about what we are expecting? He said that, Olorun ti se. He said, the Lord has done it. I said, wow. He said, the Lord has done it. I said, what trimester are you now? He said, I'm on my 5th trimester. Hallelujah. She's pregnant. I said, wow. Hallelujah. Why won't I dance before the Almighty God? Why won't I dance before the Almighty God? Why won't I praise God? On Sunday, I was opportune to worship with worship in the church of my partner, Pastor Olasuko Ayeni, at Redeem, at Ikotun. And a sister that also is also part of our online fellowship. And she got our attention and told us that right now, God has done it. She has found her Isaac. They are now a relationship. Why won't I dance before God? That this is a sister that has been trusting God for years over Isaac. Now the Lord has done it. In fact, she's even bringing that brother to introduce him to us, to introduce him to me and Pastor Olasuko Ayeni. Why won't I appreciate God? I was so excited last Sunday. I was happy. Brethren, that is why I will continue to exercise my faith. For some time now, we have been asking our brethren that we need money to pay for our Zoom subscription because it expired October and they've been sending me mails. Only one person gave. And how much is left? Over 50% or so. And I just trusted God. And about 2 days ago, the Lord laid in my heart that called this sister and tell her to make up the money. And I obeyed. And I just called her. I said, sister, our money is not yet completed. Oh yeah, make up the money. It's how much I told her. All right, send me the account. And I sent the account, and lo and behold, in the next few minutes, he did it. Now, by God's grace, either today or tomorrow, we are going to pay our Zoom subscription for 2022. Why won't I praise God? God has given us people that we can just call. Say, please, make up that money. And they'll just pay without complaining. And she paid. And yesterday, she called and said that God surprised her that she received some money in dollar without knowing how the money came. Just saw the money in her account. I said, sister, that is a sign. God has just started with you. Because you obey God without even shirking. Because you obey God, God Almighty will see to it that you too will get a surprise package. Just as God launched a surprise attack, God will launch your surprise miracle to you as you have come to praise Him this day in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Father. Labor Santa Napa Pala Kusiado. Yenela Papa Luki Adena Soto Nekuado. Brethren, I want you to pray for the next few minutes because we're going to round up now. Hallelujah. Because I have to obey our agreement. 60 minutes, we shut down. Brethren, I just want to give you a few minutes to talk to the Lord. You have come, you have praised God. I've just shared testimonies to you to hear what God is doing. You may not know, but I will know because I'm the one that calls the people. I call our brethren. I call them to know how far they are doing, to know what's going on, and they give me feedback. God is working. God is doing miracles. He's working miracles. Yes. Is it miracle of conception? Is it miracle of giving birth without any challenge? Is it a miracle of somebody who is impotent and God now heals that 2 years of impotence and now he can perform with his wife, and the wife is now happy without using any juju, without using any charm or any fetish, just pray to the name of Jesus and God is doing it, and you say that God is not here, then you are blind. Then you cannot see. Then you are deaf. Then you cannot hear. But I believe that you are not blind. I believe that you are not deaf. And that is why if you too can think deeply, if you can think deeply, you will know that God has been so good to you. God has been so good to you that you are able to see today. We started together, and here you are. Some have gotten discouraged. They've stepped back. But you continue with us. As you continue with us, yes, we are not perfect yet, but you believe in us, I tell you, very, very soon, you will see on this platform, you will see people who are blind, eyes open. Those whose ears are deaf, you see their ears open. Those who are dumb, you will see them speaking. You will see real miracles happening on this platform. In the name of Jesus, those that are dead will come back. Look, I was in the place. I went to enjoy my Christmas with the family. Thank you, Jesus. God is working, I tell you, just listen to me. I went to have a nice time. I told the brother, I said, I've come just to enjoy myself. I've not come for any prayer, whatever. But, well, fortunately, we pray, sir. As we were praying, the mother-in-law almost passed on. That was how they quickly called us, and we rushed into her room, and we laid our hand on her, and we were just saying, let there be peace. The elder woman, the grandma, who was jacking, about to give up, everything calmed down. And about a few hours ago, I called the son-in-law. I said, how far, my man called? I said, everything normalized. Is God not wonderful? Is God not wonderful? The devil wanted to take mama away. I said, mama is going to cross and enter into 2022. Mama will see it. I said, relax. It's not your time. I know she will go. Yes, because I already have seen it. I said, I've seen it. I know she will go, but she will cross 2000. And that was why I snapped with her. Yeah, I snapped with her. I smile with her. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want you to believe God. God is working. Tell yourself, my miracle has started. Put it on the dashboard. Say, my miracle has started. My long-awaited miracle has started. What you say, you will get. What you say, you will get. My miracle has started. My own miracle has started. I know it. And that is why I am excited. For days now, I have been singing and dancing before God. Because my miracle has started. I don't know about you. My miracle has started in the name of Jesus. And very, very soon, I will come on this platform to testify, to tell you that my miracle that I told you that I started, this is the miracle. I will show you the evidence. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Brethren, I want you to begin to pray now. Like I said, we have just less than 5 minutes to go. The able say tena papa liki adena suntone satena papa la kuria kafedena papa yadena kuwa. Begin to tell the Lord. Tell the Lord now what you want the Lord to do for you. All your miracles that are meant for you to enjoy this year, they will not go anywhere. They will not go with the year. They must manifest in your life. The year is not yet gone. We have 2 days to go. It does not take God a second to change your life, to transform your life. Yes. Father in heaven, I decree and I declare every expectation of our brethren, Father, including myself, and those that will listen to this ministration via our YouTube channel, Father, as they will connect to it and they will believe you, Father, for their own miracle, Lord God Almighty, like you said, believe the Lord and you have established. Believe his prophet and they will believe in us. Father in heaven, whatever is your long awaited expectation for this year yet to manifest, Father, within these 2 days, Lord, create Satan, Papa, Yakul, whatever you have to do, like you did for the Jehoshaphat, if you arise you to come down physically, Baba, come down physically in your presence, with your presence, come down physically in your power, and do and give them that which is their expectation. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And as we have also come, Father, to talk to you, Father, with after dancing, my Lord and my God, Father, whatever is our miracle for 2022, as we are hitting 1st of January, let those miracles begin to manifest. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, our enemies, bury them now. In the name of Jesus, let our enemies begin to fight themselves to death. In the name of Jesus, let them help each other to kill themselves. Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, you have done it before, do it again. All our unrepentant enemies, all our unrepentant enemies, those that are bound with the devil, those that have covenanted with the devil, that until they see our end, they will not stop. Father, right now, Father, gather them together and let them begin to fight themselves. In the name of Jesus, let them turn enemies against themselves until the last person will kill himself or kill herself. In the name of Jesus. Father, we say thank you. Oh, Father, we say thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. All right, just in the next 2 minutes, we shall shut that now. But let me give us this instruction. I want you to listen to me. Next, our first prayer fellowship will come up the first Tuesday, first Wednesday, January 2022. Please, when you are coming, because the Lord has declared that it's going to be our year of great possibility. Our year of great possibility. Of course, you'll be hearing other things. They are all working together. Like my partner said, that the Lord told him that 2022, my year of excellence. Yes. To some, yes, say my year of excellence. And many will be coming up. We'll be hearing more. They are all interrelated. Hallelujah. Now, this is what's going to happen. Please write 3 major events that you want to experience in 2022. I know that there will be a lot of events, but write 3 major events. Like me now, one of my major events is that I'm leaving Nigeria. Yes, I know I'm leaving Nigeria next year. I'm leaving Nigeria. I'm relocating next year. So it's one of my major events I want to see. So you to have 3 major events which you know that humanly speaking is not possible. Yeah, 3 major events, 3 major. Don't come and say, next year I want God to give me $1,000, $2,000, $10,000, $100,000. That's rubbish. That's not major. That one, anybody can just give you $100,000. Yes, that one is rubbish. I'm talking about 3 major events. Write them down. And when you write them down, listen to the instruction. When you write them down, put them inside an envelope. Seal that envelope and address it to Almighty God. Say, my 3 major events in 2022 to my Father God, right? I don't know how you call your own God. To Papa God, to Baba God, put it there, seal it. And then on our first day off, we'll pray on it. Then snap that front page where you wrote, I don't want to know what is inside. It's already sealed. Just snap the front of the envelope and send it to my WhatsApp. That's all. Then what I will do with it is it's none of your business. Just send it to me. Anyway, I don't know what is inside, but that is the instruction. 3 major events. I'm going to do it. I'll snap it, put it there, and give it to me. And then, and let's continue with the Lord. And continue to praise the Lord. Don't stop these praises. And I'm telling you, before December, open that envelope. You will see that what you wrote down have manifested. Because 2022, my year of great possibility. Faithful with God. By the grace of God, we are going to dwell on that scripture, with God, what does it mean? What does it mean? With God, all things are possible. You can't be in partnership with God and nothing happens to you. A war. Hallelujah. Next year is a year of great possibility. Father, we thank you. Lord, as we go with us. In the name of Jesus. Father, thank you because we are blessed. Baba, we are blessed. Ha, we are blessed. Thank you, Father, that we came to close the year, our last fellowship with you. We dancing, we praise it. And our fourth vigil next year, we are going to open it again. We praise it, we dancing again. Father, the devil is already mad. The devil is in soup, and we are making it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And the three major events that we're going to put down, you will do exceedingly above all that we put down come 2022. And by December, we shall use all of December to praise you, to glorify you. We promise you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Those that I know, one of their major events is getting pregnant and getting and delivering that baby. Some of us is getting married. It's a major event and you are getting married. Yes. Write it down and see what God will do. Hallelujah. All right. Thank you, Jesus. Now let's bring the fellowship to a close. Let's share the grace in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, which is always sweet and wonderful, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. And I say a big amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.